Hey, it's Thomas here, and today we're going to be checking out Fiji Cube's all-in-one standard aquarium drop-in kit. If you want a super easy way to convert your standard glass aquarium into an affordable all-in-one system with a pre-built drop-in solution that doesn't require any silicone or tools to install, provides surface skimming, mechanical filtration, space for your preferred media, and a place to hide equipment like your heater or ATO, then check out Fiji Cube's all-in-one drop-in kit. All-in-one aquariums are super popular. They give you similar benefits and features to those that you would get with an overflow and sump system in a simpler and more compact design. So for reefers who want surface skimming, filtration that doesn't hang on behind or inside the tank, and a place to hide equipment without the plumbing and complexity of an overflow system and external sump, an all-in-one system is a really good option. All-in-one tanks also tend to be less expensive than similarly sized aquariums that are drilled with an overflow system and have an external sump, but they are more spendy than a standard glass tank paired with a good hang-on or internal filter, which is likely why some hobbyists that are reefing on a budget have gone the DIY route to get that all-in-one functionality and look in a standard glass tank. DIY is not for everyone though. If you don't already have the tools or lack the experience working with them, or just aren't a particularly patient person, there is another option to get that DIY all-in-one tank with your standard aquarium without all the hassle that's associated with doing all that DIY stuff from scratch. Fiji Cube's drop-in all-in-one kits are a great way to convert an Aquion and a variety of other standard aquariums into an all-in-one peninsula-style tank. They take seconds to install, provide surface skimming, mechanical filtration, and space to add your own preferred filter media, as well as hide equipment like your heater or your ATO, and can save you around half the cost of buying a prefabricated all-in-one tank. And if a peninsula tank isn't really your thing, you could definitely place this filter box on the back panel of the tank instead of the side. But before we get into all that, let's get it out of the box. In the box, you'll find the drop-in all-in-one filter box, the filter sock and holder, the outflow fittings and tubing, the installation magnet, as well as installation brackets with thumb screws. There are a number of sizes available to fit Aquion as well as a variety of other standard aquariums, including 10 gallon, 20 long, and 40 breeder aquariums. All of the models are 4¾ inches from front to back with a width and height that match the side panel of the aquarium for a nice fit that creates a peninsula style all-in-one tank. All three models include an optional filter sock and bracket for mechanical filtration and include fittings and tubing for installing a return pump. The 10 and 20 long models have a pair of baffles to create two separate chambers, one for water entry and another larger chamber for equipment and the return pump, while the 40 breeder model has three with an extra baffle that divides the larger second chamber. Installation is also really simple. The boxes are enclosed on all sides, including the back, with a clear panel, so you aren't limited to siliconing them in place, although you can do it. You can also use a super fast and less permanent approach with the included magnet or clips. You will want to pick up a small return pump to get the water flowing. The recommended flow rates for each filter are provided so you can match it up nicely with a simple and reliable pump. For example, I'd probably use one of CJ's micro pumps for this 10 gallon version. The flow rate is right within range and it has the exact same half inch output, which will fit the tubing on this perfectly. And it's a really small pump, so it leaves lots of extra space for media and other gear. Once the return pump's installed, you're ready to start adding your favorite media, a heater, an ATO, and other equipment to get your DIY all-in-one aquarium ready to reef. I also wouldn't be surprised to see reefers using this for their quarantine setups as well, especially if you prefer to keep things looking tidy and inside of the tank as opposed to hang-on options. I think the ability to use it temporarily with the magnets or brackets has an advantage here and makes sterilizing and cleaning the aquarium and filtration easier in between batches of fish. When it comes to savings, setting up one of these drop-in all-in-ones costs around half as much as buying a prefab all-in-one aquarium. You can really dial in the savings if you pick up a standard glass tank during one of those dollar per gallon sales, or if you find a secondhand aquarium in great shape. If you're newer to reefing, or you're setting up your first reef tank and you're trying to decide between an all-in-one system like this or a standard tank with some hang-on gear, there is an awesome 5-minute guide series that you can watch. It's right here, goes through everything. Ryan breaks it all down for you, whether it's picking out the tank, picking out the best gear for beginners, fish, corals, all of it, condensed down into 5-minute episodes, super easy to understand, walks you through everything, including pests and how to deal with them. So enjoy the journey, get it all done in one shot, don't buy equipment twice, have a watch. Get what's right for you.